Now let's talk about heat emergencies. You see, heat emergencies can occur when the body's temperature regulation systems become overwhelmed by excessive heat. Knowing how to assess and provide first aid for these emergencies is vital. This video will guide you through the assessment and initial treatment of heat cramps, heat exhaustion, and heat stroke. Let's take a closer look. Heat cramps are painful muscle contractions that typically occur during physical activity in hot weather. If someone experiences heat cramps, guide them to a cool place, a shaded area, and have them rest. Encourage the person to drink fluids, preferably containing electrolytes. Gently massage the affected muscles and apply a cool compress if available. Remember to create a cool environment and promote rehydration for heat cramps. Secondly, is heat exhaustion. Heat exhaustion is a more severe condition resulting from prolonged exposure to high temperatures and inadequate fluid intake. Signs of heat exhaustion include profuse sweating, pale skin, weakness, dizziness, headache, and nausea. Move the person to a cool location. Indoors with air conditioning is best, but at least a shaded area. Have them lie down and loosen or remove excess clothing. Apply cool, wet cloth or towels to their body and use fans or misting water to cool the patient down. Offer them small sips of water or a sports drink if they can swallow without nausea. Monitor these patients until they feel better or consider calling EMS or further medical treatment for more severe cases. Prioritizing cooling, rehydration, and rest is crucial for the treatment of heat exhaustion. Now, as the body becomes even more dehydrated and overheated, it moves from heat cramps to heat exhaustion, and then from that, it goes all the way into heat stroke. Heat stroke is a life-threatening emergency characterized by a dangerously high body temperature. Since these patients can no longer control their body temperatures, they'll start with all of the previous symptoms and then transition into hot, dry skin and an altered mental status. They might even go unresponsive. So call emergency services immediately when this is seen, as heat stroke requires prompt medical attention. While waiting for help, move the person to a cool area and remove excessive clothing. Make sure to cool their body rapidly using any means available, immersion in cool water, spraying them with a hose, applying cool water-soaked towels, or even ice packs in the armpits, groin, or next to the neck. We need to cool these patients quickly. However, you might be cooling them too fast if they start shivering. It's best not to provide fluids to these patients since they may not be able to swallow safely and it can make them vomit, further dehydrating them and complicating their airways. Cooling the body rapidly and activating emergency medical services is a priority in heat stroke cases. While many cases of heat stroke can happen to students playing sports, employees on construction sites or in hot factories, remember that the elderly can be prone to heat stroke during hot summer months, right inside their very homes. Remember, early recognition and intervention are critical in heat emergencies. So stay vigilant, plan for extra fluids, and rest on hot days to help avoid these heat-related illnesses.